Welcome to our Alexos 3 training video. In this video, we will show you how to complete a basic setup for cataract surgery using the Alexos 3. Connect the main power cord to the power supply. Ensure that the pedal connector is locked into place by lining up the two red dots on the machine and the pedal connection. To set up the device, you can either place the Alexos 3 onto an IV pole, or onto a counter next to the surgical table. If you're attaching it to an IV pole, fasten the locking mechanism onto the IV pole. Ensure that it is screwed tightly into place on the IV pole. Place the machine onto the locking mechanism, ensuring that it locks into place. You'll hear a click. Select the on/off switch situated at the back of the machine to power on. If the startup function has been completed successfully, the system ready message will be displayed. From the startup screen, select the desired phaco program from the memory, using the plus and minus keys on the upper right-hand side of the display panel. Select phaco using the function key on the display panel. Get the handpiece and cassette components ready for setup. Phaco tip, sleeve and test chamber, IA cassette with tubing, phaco handpiece. Make sure that the height of the machine is level with the patient's head. Ensure that the BSS bottle or bag is elevated at approximately 100 centimeters above the patient's head. Please pay careful attention to the following step. Now, connect the cassette. Insert it, ensuring that the guide pin on the back of the cassette lines up with a port on the cassette slot. Holding the cassette at a 45 degree angle, rotate it downwards. Insert the locking mechanism into the first holding mount. Grasp the second locking mechanism, and gently pull the tubing over the pump wheel, and secure it into the second holding mount. Slightly pull the infusion line to the left towards and behind the irrigation valve. Once the tubing is in the correct position, the irrigation valve will activate, clamping the tube. Hang the drainage bag by securing it onto the drainage holder. Ensure the clamp is open when the device is in use. Secure the drainage tube from the cassette to the drainage bag or bottle. Connect the giving set to the BSS bottle or bag. Fill the chamber halfway with BSS by squeezing. Remove the protection caps from the cassette infusion port and giving set. Connect the giving set to the infusion port of the Alexos cassette. Connect the phaco handpiece to the Alexos 3 device. The plug of the phaco handpiece has a blue ring that matches the plug with the blue ring on the machine. The arrows must be visible once connected. Please note that the tubing that connects to the phaco handpiece must be kept sterile. Connect the irrigation and aspiration lines to the ports on the phaco handpiece. Make sure that the connections are secure. Unscrew the protective cap from the phaco handpiece. Mount the tip gently but tightly in a clockwise direction until it locks into position. Remove the key by pulling in a straight line. Place the sleeve over the phaco tip. Get the sleeve orientation correct by adjusting the irrigation sleeve until the phaco tip extends beyond the sleeve about 1 mm. Secure the test chamber over the irrigation sleeve. Pull the test chamber over the tip and sleeve until the back end is flush with the irrigation sleeve. Ensure that the inline valve and the air filter on the giving set are open, so the fluid can run freely through the tubing. Place the handpiece at a 45 degree angle to ensure optimal priming. Press the pre-op button to start the priming cycle. Ensure that a phaco function has been selected in order for the pre-op to test the system's phaco power. The machine automatically fills the test chamber. The phaco tip must be completely submerged in fluid. Allow the machine to run through the cycle until it displays test OK. The device is now ready for surgery. If desired, you can cover the foot pedal with a plastic bag to protect it from the fluid. Please remember that this is a basic guide for setup. Refer to the Alexos 3 user manual for complete instructions, or contact Anvision for further support. Thank you.